went to Nelson Street Boys RC. From there, I went to secondary school, to Bath, Virginia Secondary, and from there, I was in the conference. Well, I started playing at a young age, probably like about 5, 6. And I think the biggest influence I had was my uncle, one called Jubal, one called Pusha. They were good footballers in the community, in the village, Malachis. And I think going to the games with them at that early age, running on the pitch while it's at halftime, match pass back then when you had to match the teams on them. So that was one of the biggest influences.
Well, there's so many to really name, but I think the best moment for me personally is in secondary school football for Sawa Senior Comprehensive, when I scored 4 hat tricks consecutively. And I think that was a crowning moment, which is a record I think still in school football that hasn't been broken, or probably internationally around the world, because it was recognized by FIFA. It was played under FIFA law, and it was in the year of 1992 with Sawa Senior Comprehensive. I think Pro League now, there's an up and there's a down. I think basically when I first came into the Pro League back in 2005, 2006, I think, and I came in with our Northeast Stars, and from there I went to Caledonia, from there to Jabuti, and I'm with Central FC now. But when I first started in the Pro League, it was a lot of energy was pumped into the league. They used to have like magazines, they used to have like awards and things, player of the month, and stuff like that used to be given away, and we have players that I really looked to strive to achieve something. But on the playing level, the level wasn't that high. But I think now, with the management and the administrative part of the Pro League, I think it dipped a little, and with the play of the players, I think the level have risen. I think there's a lot more quality now today than there was back probably 6 years ago. And the league is growing in the players' capacity of playing on the pitch, but I think it has to grow back in the administrative part. The biggest stadium I ever played in was in Giant Stadium in New York. I represented Staten Island Vipers against, I think we played against Metro Stars at that time. They are called the Red Bulls now. That was back, I think, in 99 or 19. Somewhere back there. The biggest match I ever played in my life. There are so many to play, but I think me personally is when I won the Pro League with Jabuti back in 2008. When we played W Connection, it was a game at 2 o'clock. 2 o'clock, yeah, 2 p.m. hot start. Wasn't much crowd, but the atmosphere for the game, they had it to beat us to win the championship. We just needed a tie or a win, and the guys dig deep. We was a young team, Atula Guerra, and guys like that was on the team, Cornell Glenn, Trent Noel, myself, you know what I mean? Peter Byers, and a real good bunch of guys, and under the guidance of Terry Frederick. I think that was one of the biggest matches in my life to actually win the Pro League title in my life. Well, on the topic of cricket, which is a favorite, probably to all ghetto youth, I love to go to the wake, get the cricket for the cheese and stuff like that, cricket and peanut butter at home. Just love cricket, but I think my best thing with the cricket is when I put it in the tea, you break it up and I kind of something substitute for cornflakes. If you can't afford the cornflakes, try it. Get the cream, make sure it's fresh. Get a cup of tea, milk, thing, break it up, mash it up, thing, and delicious. Trust me. Well, Central FC on the season so far. Aretas give us a B. Think it have been an A, but to the start with the guidance of Mr. Graham Ricks, which was a good coach, in my opinion, and with Lindsay, who get us fit and had us ready and things. I think at that time it was more on the players not adapting well to a professional situation, being given the freedom to act like a professional and not being demanded to be a professional. And I think what is happening now is that they are being demanded to be a professional, so the attitude had to change. And when the attitude change, you get the consistency, you get the level of play rate, you get the level of fitness, the level of strength, everything has risen up just because they act now like a professional and it is demanded on you. When he was first given that role to carry out himself like a professional, he didn't take it in the right way, and he made mistakes early in the season that cost us. But I think right now we are one of the teams to watch in the league. May not win the Pro League season this year, but I think we'll win the fans and even our own players and things with the way we play and how we playing. Football is all I know. I wouldn't be a plumber. I wouldn't be an electrician. I wouldn't be a police officer or a soldier. You know what I mean? My father, my mother always tell me, whatever you good in, always shoot faith. And in football, I never turn my back on it, and it never turned it back on me. It's always been good to me, always been patient, gave me everything I have, give my beautiful kids. Through football, met my beautiful friend, my beautiful mother and them. So it's always been good to me, and I have to give back to my community. And not even just the community, but to learn to be on the whole and even the Caribbean. With the knowledge and things that I've learned abroad, just putting it back, and yes, I will be